It's Caroline Herbert here from BBTV. I'm here with John Pegg, trainer of Sam Eggington. What did you make of his performance tonight?
Great performance. You know, the guy was unbeaten, he was tough, he wanted to win. And after four rounds, I had to tell Sam to box, because the guy was trying to Sam Eggington. We've done that to too many fighters, took everything they've got to offer and broke them afterwards. And I thought, the fucker's trying to do to us what we do to them. So I calmed him down, I got him just boxing smart behind a jab. And then once his second win come, we went again. But he was a tough man, and when you're unbeaten, I've just been over and seen him, and he's in tears because he wanted to win so much and he believed he could win. They're hard people to beat, but the result was the important thing. And you know, Sam's done his job, and I'm just massively proud of him, you know what I mean?
Pretty impressive, isn't it? Gone from walking into the gym wanting to be a journeyman to IBO champion of the world.
After one spar, I knew he's never going to be a journeyman. He actually come down and beat one of your countrymen in his first fight.
Yes.
Leon Findlay, a good fighter.
Yes.
When he was just 18. And when he beat Leon, I thought, this kid's going to do something, you know. I kind of knew anyway, but... And then every time people have wrote him off, he's been old school. He hasn't let a loss destroy him. He's let a loss improve him. And, you know, he's a handful. He's a veteran. He's been around the block. You know, he knows how to get through fights, he knows how to win fights. And I think tonight was his just dessert, you know what I mean? He really deserved what tonight was, and I'm just over the moon. I'm very rarely smiling and happy, but tonight I'm very, very happy.
You didn't look in the corner at times when Sam was going a bit mad, because he was boxing really nicely at the start, behind his jab rolling, yeah. And then Sam fancied getting him out of it, and I could hear you, relax.
The problem is, if somebody stays on the feet and you gamble to get them out of there, you might empty the tank, yeah? And even though Sam's got a great engine, nobody's infallible. Anybody can fail to empty the tank. And that guy was tough. So I had to make sure that Sam kept enough in the tank to keep going. You know, he's had a long, hard career. So when you're winning comfortably, why gamble on something that you don't need at that moment? So I had to, luckily, Sam knows me well enough that when I tell him something, he usually tries, you know what I mean? So we got there.
Yeah, and a winner as well elsewhere in the night for Corey Gibbs.
Yeah, Corey boxed class. He's a very tough Spanish champion. His first eight rounder. I think Corey goes for a title in his next fight, to be honest. He's a lovely boxer. We don't send him chasing knockouts. He's an artist in the ring, but Corey boxed great. Casey Benjamin took on the chin that his opponent failed a medical the day before. He got a guy a stone heavier, didn't let it faze him, didn't let it bother him, went in there, won well, and hopefully we're getting one more before his mandatory fight with the winner of Dalton Smith and Samo Mason.
Yeah, that's a good fight coming up. And yeah. What else is coming up for the fighters in your gym? What else is lined up for
them? I've got a big show next week. I had a show last week. They've all been kind of shoehorned into June. I've got a show next week with Ishmael Ellis headlining against Joe Ducker for the Midlands. Got an 11 fight show at the Solihull Ice Rink in Birmingham, big new venue. We've just had a show where we had all our prospects make their debuts last week. We had a great show there. So, you know, there's 12 boxers in our gym that we train personally. And then I manage about another 20 around Birmingham and the Midlands. So we're having lots of shows, keep them busy, and they all take their chances when they get them. River Wilson Bent didn't win tonight, but he come through a hard 10-round war, lost a split decision, and he was very upset, but I just turned around to him and says, look at that kid there, he's had 7 losses, he's fighting for a world title tonight.
Yeah.
So, you know, Sam's such a good kind of figurehead to have, because nobody gets too down about a bad night or a bad loss, because he's shown that you take it on the chin, you learn from it, and you become a better fighter. So it's a good example to the rest of the lads in the gym.
It's almost the UFC mentality where a loss doesn't matter. So what do you want to see next for Sam?
I want to see either a big, stupid payday, like ridiculous, that, you know, he deserves more than anyone. Or I want to see a defence that someone isn't unbeaten. Sam's took more unbeaten records than Ricky Hatton and Amin Khan did combined. And check that statistic, he's took more unbeaten records than Ricky and Amir combined. That's some statistic, you know what I mean?
Yeah, get him on a pitch at Villa Park.
do you know what? He's not really a football man, but I've got a few meet and greets lined up for him. He's very good with the fans. He's going to be at our show next week, the big show. He's going to be there. He's going to go to a few sporting clubs that I've promised if he wins the belt, he'll be there. You know, we're going to enjoy a few weeks.
It's a nice belt as well, isn't it?
It's a beautiful belt. It's a world championship belt. It's everything to it.
Wicked. Thank you, John.
Thank you, Carmen. And I always enjoyed watching your results and fights. It's a shame that you've retired because you're a good fighter.
I'm not quite retired yet. I might be back.
Well, if you come back to one of our shows, you'll be welcome.
Okay, brilliant. Cheers, John.
Thank you, Carwin.